question. I think about me and you. I think about us and the society. And I also think about those corrupted persons who are fighting for corrupting the corruption. Greetings of the day to all the spectators. I am Lavanya Malik and I am representing the TED-Ed Club of Eicher School, Parwanoo. The main idea of our team is Vision 2050, a developing nation. The topic on which I will give a presentation is corruption. Corruption is 1 million times bigger than the Everest and the same amount of times deeper than the deepest oceans. But as a matter of fact, corruption is not a physical factor and is now in our DNA and is flowing within us. In our blood and our heart is pumping it, loving it and nurturing it like nothing else. By looking at others, we cannot see corruption. Rather, we have to look within us to see the mightiness of corruption. The entire body of the society is corrupted. So, just we cannot alone blame the politicians, executives, judiciary, business persons and anyone else for promoting corruption. Corruption is not a pebble that you can pick it up and throw it like it is nothing. Can we make India corruption free? Can we really fight against us? Well, likewise, thousands of questions are raised every day by you and me. And the answer is yes. Yes, we can eradicate corruption from India. But let me make it crystal clear to you that we cannot eradicate corruption by just changing laws, by doing hunger strikes, street fighters on the roads, nor we can eradicate it by the virtue of the some people fighting for the removal of corruption from India. And let me also tell you that the dramas you watch on the television and the stories you read on the internet are not and never going to help you in any way to fight with corruption. So what to do? How to eradicate corruption from India? So let me tell you some of the possible ways to fight and win over corruption. As a matter of fact, let me tell you that we cannot eradicate corruption at the midnight. It will definitely take the necessary amount of time and anything all of a sudden will have terrible consequences. So the first and the foremost thing we can do is change in law. Some people believe that by making certain changes in laws and refreshing the old laws with new twists, we can diminish the tower of corruption. Well, I believe that it will help only 0.05% or even less. There are holes in laws, many holes, and these holes are for eternity. So just by tweaking here and there, nothing great could be achieved. But it will definitely help. So we must bring the necessary changes to our municipal laws. Second, bringing awareness among people. We must bring awareness among people about corruption. It seems a big joke to me, but we Indians, with the help of God and with the blessing of God, are much more aware about corruption than many Western countries. In fact, that day when people will say, "What is corruption? Pardon, we have never heard of it," will be the day of wisdom for India. Attempts should be made to educate citizens in regard to their rights, responsibilities and the procedure of the government. Well, their points will not touch corruption, but will not even pinch it. So, the nuclear bomb, or in local words, Brahmastra, that can completely destroy corruption from India is this: hate and abandon. Well, we need to hypnotize ourselves, our society, men, women, children, and every single person of us, India. Not to hate corruption, because we all hate corruption, but to hate the corrupt people. I think this is the wisdom of the day. Every person of India should hate and treat the corrupt persons just in the very same way in which our ancestors, high class people, used to treat the untouchables at that frame of time. Every corrupt person should be treated as an untouchable, and every innocent person of the society should hate the corrupt person from within the deep cores of his heart. A corrupt person's family should be treated as an alien family. And the basic facilities of education, services and business licenses should not be provided to them. Unless and until they eliminate and abandon the corrupt person from their family. So, I would like to conclude my presentation by saying just a few lines that we are the reason behind corruption prevailing, and it is again we who can put our sincere efforts and abolish this social evil. So friends, let us join our hands together and make our country corruption free and a better place to live in. Thank you.